God. They said the God to the Hebrews had come into the camp.
Come on.
Everybody's knees is knocking.
Come on.
And the Bible said, one of them Philistines said, quit yourself and fight like men.
Come on.
Brother, that devil's going to find out whether you got what you say you got.
Come right. on. Come on.
He'll send that naked woman out there in front of you.
Come on.
He'll send that man out there to talk sweet to you.
Come on. Ladies.
Better watch it, brother. Sometimes he'll try to send a man to talk to you.
Come on.
Now it's politically correct to be a queer.
Come on.
Come on now. But it ain't correct according to the word of God.
Amen.
Come on, it's an abomination.
Amen.
And that's what we got now, an abomination
Amen.
Nation. Amen. Since we got Obama in there,
Amen.
But that's all right. God's made provision.
Amen.
I said God's made a way for those
yeah.
that are holding on to the truth and not bow and not bend. God has made a way tonight.
Yes, amen.
Preacher, that's offensive. Oh. Well, you're just getting offended by the word of God.
Amen. Preaching.
Quit yourself and fight like men, lest you be servants to the Hebrews.
Amen.
You know what happened next? Was it 34,000? Total 30,000 more died, wasn't it?
Amen.
I think it was 30,000 more, Brother J.J., died. And the ark of God was taken.
Amen.
My Lord, what are you saying, preacher? I'm saying in the day that we live, we're in such a dilemma that the word of God is being taken out of so many people's hearts and lives.
Come on.
And so many churches. Come on, man. Pushing that NIV and that all them other new translations.
Come on, man.
Amen. They're pushing out there now. And we're in a great dilemma. But God's made provision. I said, God's made a provision, brother. Amen. Come on. This is not catching God by surprise. Amen. Amen. The Bible said the ark of God was taken. They took the ark down there. They put it in the Philistines. Come on. Amen. Some fellow, while they taken the ark, whooped Israel with a whooping they couldn't handle. Amen. One fellow runs back out of the battle and goes down there and kills Eli. These two boys was killed. The ark of God was taken. We know the story. Eli fell off backwards, broke his neck. Just a few moments later, his daughter-in-law gave birth to a child, died giving birth, and they named the boy Ichabod.
Come on.
And I know everybody always says the glory hath departed. But if you look that up, the root words mean when and how.
Jesus.
How did it happen?
Jesus.
How did it take place?
Come on.
It took place because one man
yes.
didn't have enough backbone
yes.
to stand up and make his youngins do right.
Amen.
Oh God. And I want to tell you, there's a lot of things happening in America. Amen. And generations gone past and trying to happen now because
Come
people
on.
Won't stand up.
Yeah.
Amen. And stand for what's right. Listen here, I love my youngs as much as anybody else can. I put two grown boys in the graveyard, brother. I don't plan on putting the rest of them in there. I'm
Come
telling
on.
April and Tracy, you got to be right or you're going to bust hell wide open.
Come
you
got
to live right. You can't keep going like you're going. I try to
Come
tell
on.
My grandyoungs, amen. You know what? Most of them don't want to be around Papa and Nanny.
Come
you
on.
Know why? They love the world too much.
Come on.
I can't give in to the body. If I do, if I give up and give in, amen, and compromise with him, I'm not a wind up like Eli. I'm
Come
not
on.
Having nobody living in my family.
Come
I want to tell you, I can't afford that tonight.
Yes, amen.
They took that ark and took it down there, put it in that false God's house.
Yeah.
Yeah. Dagon, however you pronounce his name.
Yeah. Come on.
The Bible said in the morning, Dagon was falling down.
Yes.
They stood him back up. Next day he was broke off at the stump and his hands were broke off in his wrist. Amen. The Bible said every knee's going to bow and every tongue's going to confess.
Yes.
And Jesus Christ
yes.
is Lord of the
Amen.
Lord and Father. Amen. Every false God. Amen. Our Buddha's going to bow. Amen.
Come,
come on.
On
now. I said Muhammad and Allah. Amen. Come on. All of them going to bow.
Come
Amen.
On.
They're all going to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord
yes.
one of these days. I remember Brother Robin years and years ago. I preached a message on the day the devil's going to shout, Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty.
Yes.
One of these days, even Lucifer. He's going to bow his knee and say, He is Lord. He is
yes.
Lord. My God, there is provision made through and by Jesus.
Amen.
Oh, my. You read on in the story. I got to try to go on tonight. You read on in the story. A lot of things happen. Amen. Saul loses his kingship. He's still sitting on the throne. David's anointed king. We can read all about all this stuff happening. Amen. During this whole time, Amen. You read the story. Samuel's trying to tell the people what to do and how to act and how to live. What they need to do, though they haven't got the Ark of the Covenant. Amen. That the Bible says, amen, that the people, they got to crying. They saying, give us a king like everybody else has got. Amen. God told Samuel, said, they've not rejected you, son, but they've rejected me. Amen. Can I tell you, when folks want to have what everybody else has got, amen, come on. I want to have it because Hollywood's got it. I want to have it because so-and-so's got it. Come on now. Brother Robbie, I'll tell you what happens. Amen. To God, we don't got Jesus no more. Amen. The world's more important. Amen. That's what they were saying. We will win. That's all right. But you read the story on and on. As you read this story, lots of things happened in Israel. A lot of things took place. Amen. The Bible said that Ark of the Covenant, after it had been 7 months with the Philistines, finally, I don't remember what all happened down that day, God. I know they sent it away. Couldn't stand it. They had balls and soldiers all over them. You know, the Word of God still makes a sinner, man, or woman uncomfortable.
Amen.
The hypocrite still uncomfortable.
Amen.
From the Word of God. The hypocrite still uncomfortable.
Amen.
You know, and many times I've been preaching, amen, the Lord would direct my eyes to look somewhere and I could find folks that couldn't even look the direction I was. And I began to realize what was going on. I began to realize that they thought they had something hid, but they didn't want to look just in case.
Come
amen,
on.
Just in case, Brother Jesse.
Well,
I got news for you tonight. It don't matter whether I know it or not. It don't matter nothing I know. Amen, the only thing is God knows everything.
Amen.
There's nothing hid from Him tonight. Amen. The Bible said all things are open and naked unto Him to whom we have to do with, and nothing is hid from Him. He
amen.
Said everything is done in secret. It's going to be proclaimed from the housetop. Amen.
Yes.
I want you to know tonight, God knows what's going on
yes.
with us tonight. Amen.
Yes,
He knows. Philistines sent that thing away to another place, another little town. And over there it got so bad they couldn't stand it too. Uncomfortable, brother, they couldn't handle it. Amen. Somebody said, what are we going to do? Somebody said, I'll tell you what you need to do. You get you a couple of cows that's got some calves. We'll fix us up a cart. We'll take us some little old golden trinkets and things. We'll offer it to God as an offering. We'll put it in a coffer. We'll send it away with it. And if them cows with calves down yonder in the barn carry it away from here, amen, we'll know that God's took it back where it needs to go. And this wasn't just an accident or just something that happened to us. Amen. A lot of folks say, oh, it was just a circle. It was just a happenstance. It was just a coincidence. No, no, no. There's
some
folks tonight, your life is in shambles. You played around with God. Your life is upside down because you thought you would have something from God and appease God with your own righteousness. There's no substitute for holiness. Amen. You thought you would get by, but God's got your number.
Amen.
You can say, oh, that ain't me, preacher. It's somebody.
Hallelujah. Amen.
And it's somebody here.
God help us.
Oh, God. The Bible said they took that thing away. Blowing as the wind. And they stopped over yonder by a big old rock, Brother Robbie. Them Philistines was rejoicing when they seen that thing get out of there. You know there's people tonight, if they can get rid of that preacher that preaches the truth, they'll be rejoicing. They'll get their deacon board and about half the church members and amen, ain't nothing but busybodies and troublemakers. They'll go ahead and start voting and vote that preacher out. And they'll get another one in there if he opens that book. Won't long, they'll vote him out too. Amen, that's all right. Amen, you can't vote God out. I said, you can't put God away somewhere. Amen, He's omnipresent. He's on the scene tonight. I said, He's on the scene. I said, the Holy Ghost is on the scene. He knows tonight.
Amen.
My God. The cow stopped over yonder by some big old rock somewhere. And the Bible said when they stopped, somebody run down there rejoicing and said, look at yonder, the ark is back. Now, if you just get a hold of this thing, the Bible said that the children of Israel lamented after the ark. Now, if that had been true, I'm not saying some of them didn't, but if that had been really been true, they wouldn't have been telling Samuel, we want a king like everybody else. Come on now. They wouldn't be telling them, I'm going to get me one of them G-strings like everybody else has got. Amen. I'm here to tell you tonight, friend, God cares how you look. You can't pervert the gospel and make it all right to dress like a whore or like battle proper. And then the Bible said we're not in chamber and in wantonness. And those words, if you look at it, it means don't to look like you want to lay down in the bed chamber. Amen. But we've got folks today that claim to be Christians, and everything they do is about sex appeal. Let me flex my muscles. Let me shake what I got. I'm here to tell you that God is not pleased with that man.
Amen.
Oh, how'd you get there, preacher? I wasn't planning on it.
Blessing God. Blessing God.
When that cart and that buggy stopped, people was rejoicing. They ran down there hollering and shouting, the ark's back. Yeah. We've got it back. I know preachers that went and took churches in different places. The honeymoon was real sweet. But as soon as he stepped on somebody's toes above the living right, the honeymoon was over.
Come on now.
It wasn't long, Brother J.J. All they wanted to do was get rid of that man. Amen. The Bible said they run down there and looked at that ark and said, yeah, that's it. 50,000 of them died. I got to wondering and wondering and wondering. I said, God, why didn't you kill all them Philistines? Come on now. The Bible said only a few Philistines died.
Come on.
A lot of them had sores on them. Only a few died. And I got the question about that.
Yeah.
I said, he killed 50,000 Israelites. Because they went over and flipped the lid open on that ark and said, yeah, that's it. I couldn't figure it out, brother. And I got to think about it, Brother Stanley. Them Philistines didn't know no better. But the Israelites knew better.
Amen.
The church tonight knows better.
Yes.
And the way they've been handling the Word of God and the way they've allowed the world to creep in. I said the church knows better. And it's bringing spiritual death. We got folks not qualified to open this Word of God. Amen. Come on now. Only those who are qualified can look into the ark.
Amen.
Oh my God. Only those who are qualified can look in.
Yes. Amen.
What are you saying, preacher? I'm saying whorehoppers and whoremongers. I'm saying them folks that don't want to live right. I'm saying them folks that want to scoff and mock at God. I'm saying them folks that are half-hearted Christians, they have not the right to even open that ark. Amen. It will bring death. It will bring death to them. Amen. The Philistine didn't die because they didn't know no better. But the Israelites knew better. And God killed 50-something thousand of them in one day. And then they took the ark to Abinadab's house. Stayed there 20 years. Somebody went in there and knocked the dust off of it once in a while. Maybe just blowed it off. I don't know what they done. But there was nothing happening. Nothing. Just Abinadab's house all that time. We've got Bibles, brother, across this land. We've got preachers that got them. They don't even hardly open them anymore, Brother Bobby.
Right.
They'll get them a message off the internet.
Right.
Oh, God.
Come on now. They'll get them a message off of the book that their organization sends out once a month.
Right.
Oh, God.
Amen. But they won't open the book of all books.
Come on.
Amen. I wonder if they're scared to open it.
Come on now.
Amen. I wonder if they know better, brother, and that's why so many of them ain't opening it anymore. I remember one time we was in a revival in Effingham, South Carolina. Holy Ghost fell in that place. God delivered a demon-possessed girl, saved the whole family. God turned that thing bottom side upwards for the glory of God. And you know what, brother? That pastor, that church, after that revival, he treated me like I had the black plague. He was doing it. Close to me. I found out later, Sister Tennis, he was working in the Church of God Children's Home and there in that place in South Carolina, wherever it's at, Malden, South Carolina. He'd be over there interviewing the house parents. He'd be asking them women questions he had no business asking them. And he was scared that God was going to show it to him. And brother, sometimes God shows stuff to people. Amen. And if God shows you, Brother Bobby, it'll be right. Amen. It won't be a guesstimation. It won't be, oh, somebody here's got a big toe hurt. No, no. God will say, it's you. It's you that's in the need. It's you that ain't right.